Good afternoon, students. How are you? I hope that all of you are fine and doing well. Today's lesson is course book, learner book, lesson 4. What are you doing next week? What are you doing next week? Means planning some activities already fixed, and we are talking about it. How can we ask questions and how can we answer questions? So the thing here you want to concentrate is to say any fixed actions in the future, we use present continuous to talk about it. Present continuous means is, am, are as the auxiliary verb plus verb plus ing form. Verb plus ing form is the present continuous form. Let's talk about it. Tanya and David are sister and brother. They are sister and brother. They are very busy children. You can see a family calendar there, Monday to Sunday, the whole days, 7 days of the week, they are busy. That's why they are very busy children. Look at the family calendar. Ask and answer questions about what Tanya and David are doing each day of the week. Monday, what they are going to do. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Like this, all days of the week, what activities they have to do. What is Tanya doing on Monday? That is the question. To ask questions, you want to start with what? What are you going to do on Friday? What is David doing on Monday? Plural cases, what are? What are you? What are they? What are Tanya and David doing on Friday? They are playing football. So you can see the schedule, family calendar there. Please ask and answer questions like this. What is singular? What are plural? She is, he is, they are, I am, we are. This is the short responses. You want to complete it. See, question number 2. Just imagine that you are Tanya or David, partner A. And just take or imagine partner B also. You are a friend of Tanya or David. Phone conversation. Please write these things in the notebook. Are you doing anything on Friday? Or what are you doing on Friday? Would you like to invitation? Make an invitation also using would you like to join with us? Would you like to go for a walk? Like this, make invitation also. Let's move to the next page. Write and talk. This is important. Make a calendar for 1 week. That should be 7 days. Write activities on 3 days. Please write activities for 3 days. Write Sunday, Wednesday, alternate days or continuous days. Anyway, write activities for 3 days. Leave the other days free. So 3 days you make activities and 4 days leave free. Here are some ideas. You can use going for a bike ride, shopping with mom, going to grandpa's house, or use your own ideas. No problem. There are something is given. Three things are given. You can change. You can change. Okay. Playing football or reading a book or watching a movie. Like this, no problem. You can change. You can make changes. Don't show your calendar to your partner. You don't have. Yes, you're at home. You can seek the help of someone else and ask them to make a calendar of themselves also. Then the important thing is that you want to ask questions. What are you doing on Monday? What are you doing on Saturday? Are you doing anything on Friday? Those things. Study to use these questions in present continuous. What are you doing on Monday? Are you doing anything on Tuesday? Okay, like this, please study the things. The last thing is Question number four, you can see Sylvia, she is doing karate. Kai, he is playing football. Alex, he's walking. Who says it? Let's read. You can see six sentences there. We will read and see who is saying all these things. Playing football is exciting and fun. Playing football is exciting and fun. Playing football is exciting and surely it is by Kai because he is playing football. Then walking makes your heart beat more quickly. It is said by Alex because he preferred to walk. Number three, people do karate in many different countries. Karate. Who preferred to do karate, Sylvia? So she says that people do karate in many different countries. Number four, doing karate is difficult. You will find it difficult too. It is by Sylvia again, karate. I love going for walk. It is the best exercise. I love going for walk. It is the best exercise. Surely it is by Alex. Lots of people play football. It is good for your lungs and your muscles. Talking about football, surely it is by Kai. So the thing you want to do is, an opinion is what one person thinks. A fact is a piece of information. General information, a general truth, that is fact. A general information. Read the sentences again. Decide if each is an opinion or a fact. We have to find out. We can see there are six sentences. Classify them, categorize them, group them as fact and opinion. Just write fact, opinion like that. But we have to find out. See, we will analyze first two. Playing football is exciting and fun. Playing football is exciting and fun. Maybe, you know, in my case, just to think about it, it is fun. Is it fun or is it exciting? Maybe it is fun and exciting, but we cannot generalize it. Don't think that all the people have the same opinion. No. So it is not a fact. It is not applicable for all. So it is not a fact. It is just an opinion. Playing football is exciting and fun is an opinion. You want to write opinion like this. Question number two, you see, walking makes your heart beat more quickly, whoever it is. In case of children, adult, old people, elder people, whoever it is, walking makes our heart beat more quickly. Doing exercise, walking and running. Heart beat more quickly. We have studied it in the previous lesson. So this is a fact. It is applicable for all. Like that, check question number 3, 4, 5, 6 and write whether it is a fact or an opinion. Okay? Do the homework and revise your lessons. Thank you.